from this point, I think it is very clear. Again, I'll repeat it. Yesterday, we did what basically we talked about, the risk and return associated with the investment decision. In this investment decision, we have tried to understand the quantifiable, yeah, measurable aspect of risk in terms of calculating standard deviation, coefficient of variation, as well as the beta. When we talked about the return, we have seen that two factors are there which determines the quality or quantity of return. One is the expected return and the other is realized return. Right. So now we will be talking about, after understanding the factors which are going to govern my investment, we now have to move into the investment environment. Now, what is investment environment? The place where actually the investments are going to take place, which means what? Agar hum koi bhi cheez, if we are trying to sell or purchase anything, we need what? We need a product or a service, right? So here also, if you are making investment, you need some financial product or whether it is a financial services. Now, these product and services will operate in which environment? There has to be a financial market, am I right? So remember the first unit we did, capital market, primary market, secondary market, right?
Yes, sir.
That stock exchanges. So these all constitute the investment environment. Then somebody has to provide those products and somebody has to purchase those products. So here in today's discussion, we'll be talking about the intermediaries. You can note it down. We'll be talking about the important component. In today's class, we'll be talking about the important component of investment environment. Hi, good morning. Hi, good morning. Chivankar, right? Since you have written, then we will talk about the intermediaries. Now, what does intermediary means, Sahil?
Sir, agents.
Right. Yeah, the best way I have already discussed with you. If somebody asks you for a particular word, what does it mean? The best way is to break the word and then understand. Intermediary means in between. So what does it mean? Person who will sit between the buyer and the seller. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Right. So we'll talk about the intermediaries in a trading system. Now, when we say trading, in the sense where you are going to buy or you are going to sell the securities. Now, we are talking in terms of securities. It can be in the form of equity shares, preference shares, debentures, government bonds, and things like that. So, trading system, we need to, in security analysis and portfolio management, here, in financial environment of investment, we normally find two types of people are there. Number one is the broker and the other is called as a dealer. Now, these are the two people who are acting as an intermediaries between the buyer of the security and the seller of the security. Now, brokers are the agents for buying and selling of securities, and for that they are getting the required brokerage commission. Now, brokerage commission in the sense, deal finalize ko karane ke process ko bolte hain, that is, this finalization of a deal of buying and selling is basically a part of your commitment towards purchase of financial assets or security. Now, broker kya hota hai? He is a person who tries to mediate in between and he gets the deal in your favor by allowing you to purchase the securities. Iske liye he will charge a brokerage commission. The next is a dealer who acts as a principal and sell the securities on their own account. Now, what does it mean? Difference between broker and a dealer. Who would you like to deal with, a dealer or a broker? Dealer is a person.
Dealer.
For instance, if I say that I am selling Maruti cars and I act as a broker, and if I say I am a Maruti car dealer, who is more trustworthy?
Sir, dealer.
Obviously, right? So dealer act as a principal and sell security on their own account, which means, for example, there are people who will act as a broker. That means they will mediate in between. But when I say that a person is a dealer, then he takes the responsibility also because he's acting on behalf of the principal company. For example, if I represent Reliance Industry as a dealer, that means I have been selected by Reliance to represent Reliance Industry in Kanpur as a dealer, right? So there are two things which we will remember. Number one is that the trading system for financial environment requires two types of people. One is called as a broker and the other is called as dealer. Now, Then the second intermediary, which we now see, try to understand this in a financial environment, investment environment from a bigger perspective. Normally, when we are making purchase or sales, the money transfer happens through which channel? Cash or bank?
Bank.
Right? So, jo hum paise ka, iska matlab, we have to see that one of the intermediaries would be also the banking services. So, now we'll be talking about the banking services. I will share the screen with you so that you can see that screen. I could. Can you see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
Good. So now if you look into it, I'll take a couple of seconds to adjust it. Right. So we are talking about the banking services. And in this banking services, there is one word called universal banking. It's basically a system in which banks provide wide variety of comprehensive financial services. That includes basically the commercial banking. Now, commercial banking means banking services offered to the people at large. Then we have term lending, retail operation, investment banking, mutual funds, pension funds, insurance funds, underwriting of issue securities, etc. Now, the most important part of this universal banking is basically very popular in America and US. But here, if you talk in terms of the universal banking is also available, but in a different name. Now, what is the advantage of these type of banking services offered in the terms of universal banking? The advantage is it comes from the economies of scale and direct mobilization of the fund. What does it mean, Sahil, economies of scale?
Sorry, sir?
What does it mean, economies of scale means?
Sir, ek scale pe hota hai, matlab ki ek minimum range hoti hai inki.
See, for example, if I am running a bank, right? Pragya, try to understand, if I am having a bank branch and I have only 15 customers, so is it possible that I will reduce my banking department to 15 customers? No, sir. Yes, sir. No, right? Which means I have to have a cash counter, I have to have a branch manager, I have to have a credit officer, I have to have a collection center. Iska matlab kya hua? Jo meri per head operational fixed cost ya per customer operational fixed cost hai, wo kitni hogi? Zyada hogi ki kam hogi, Pragya?
Sir, kam hogi.
Zyada hogi kyunki customer kam hai. To agar mere jo regular, for example, jaisa main class mein batata tha, if I am taking class for 2 students, so whatever amount of salary which I am getting will be per unit basis per high or low?
Low, sir, low.
No, it will be very high. Low. The reason is because 2 people are absorbing my salary. But if at the same time, agar main 60 students ko padha raha hu, then what will happen? My salary will be divided by 60 students. So per unit salary meri kam hogi ki zyada?
Kam hogi, sir. Kam
hogi. Right. That's what I am trying to say. Banking services ko itni sari services agar koi bank aapko offer kar raha hai, so what does it mean? They are trying that anyhow they should get a bank ke liye maximum advantage situation kya hoti hai? To have maximum number of customers. When maximum number of customers lane ke liye unko apni variety of services ko badhana padta hai. So universal banking mein is cheez ka fayda hota hai, right? So just an explanation to you. The next is the correspondent banking. Now, what does the word correspondent means? They are the one who will be doing various financial services. Like say, for instance, they're not directly involved in fund transfer or mobilization of fund, but they will be doing like jobs like collection of checks, data processing, right? They will be talking about security, safekeeping, loans, international transactions, things like that. We move ahead with it from correspondent banking to retail banking. It is basically a part of a commercial banking and it provides services to individuals. Now, if you say that the corporate banking ka matlab hota hai financial product and services ki jo suvidhaye di ja rahi hai, they are going to be offered to the corporate clients, right? Or the organizations or the offices. But when I talk in terms of retail banking, then these are the same type of services, but with the different terms and conditions will be offered to individual customer. Now, another important aspect which is now has emerged with the more wealth creation amongst the Indian community as well as abroad is a private banking. Now, private banking ka matlab samajh mein aata hai, what does it mean? You can read it and then explain. Pragya, what does it mean? Private banking.
Sir, in private banking, only lending and investment managements are offered for wealthy individuals.
What are wealthy individuals? I have written the word UHNI. What does this UHNI mean? They stand for, you can note it down, UHNI stands for ultra high net worth individuals.
Yes, sir.
Right? You can note it down. UHNI stands for ultra high net worth individual. These are the individual people, rich people, who are having a tremendous amount of wealth in the form of their personal net worth. These people are, you know, huge, they have a huge surplus funds in the form of a personal corpus. So banking services are offered on one-to-one basis to these customers. You can think about it, all the rich people around the globe. For them, their requirements of investments are different. Their requirement of making investments in different areas are different. For that, these banks offer a very personalized and customized services to these individuals. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Shubhankar, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What happened to your health? आपकी तबीयत नहीं अच्छी है?
नहीं सर,
सही है. Okay, fair enough. We move ahead. The another one, ये नाम आपने सुने होंगे, chips as well as Swift. Sahil, have you heard the word Swift and chips? These are not potato chips. Let me be very clear. Lay's chips नहीं है ये.
सर नाम सुने तो नहीं है, बाकी क्लियरिंग हाउस के बारे में थोड़ा बहुत जानता हूँ.
करेक्ट. Now these are the one clearing house ka kya aapko malum hai, can you explain please if you can recall?
Matlab ki sir clearing house ek jagah liye ek place decide kar li jati hai, wahan pe jitne bhi banks hote hain apne sare milki kya kehte hain financial year ke baad sare transaction leke aate hain aur reserve bank ke paas jama kar dete hain.
Right, reserve bank is the clearing house, right? Koi aisi jagah nahi hoti. It's basically the body which is governing all the nationalized as well as private banks. So they are governed by the Reserve Bank of India, and that is basically jo bhi hum checks issue karte hain, they move forward through the clearance house or the clearance agency or the clearing bank, right? Jaise maine aapko bhi piche bataya tha, correspondent bank mein check collection and clearance, ye ek important aspect hai, right? The CIPS stands for Clearing House Interbank Payment System. Now CIP is basically is a computerized fund transfer system for international dollar payments linking major US and foreign banks with offices in New York. Now aapne dekha hoga electronic form par we can now transfer funds from one account to the another account. English movies have popularly shown this type of a transfer of funds from one bank account to the another bank account. Now how does it happen? This also, like for example, if I have to make my insurance premium to ICICI, so from Bank of Baroda using net banking, then what happens? As of now, without using CIP, because in India we do not use CIP, it is only for international transactions. Say for instance, if I have to make payment for my ICICI policy of my sister who is in Canada, then I'll be using the services of CIPS. That means this clearance house will be accessing my account. From my account, I will be authorizing jo bhi amount main transfer karna chahta hu, that amount will be transferred using IFC code of my sister's account in the from the ICICI insurance, and the payment will be transferred to ICICI bank account which is operable at in Canada. Now is pure process mein, but the transfer of the fund should take place in the form of dollars. So clearance house interbank payment system CIPS jo popularly bola jata hai, it is a computerized way of transferring fund, that is online transaction. Here the physical money will not move, but the amount balances from one account to the another account in dollars will take place from one country to another country. But this is popularly very popularly used in US as well as in the offices in New York. Clear?
Okay.
Right, next is SWIFT. Now SWIFT stands for Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication, and that's called as SWIFT. It is a cooperative company that transmits financial messages, payment orders, foreign exchange confirmation, and delivery of securities to nearly 7,000 financial institutions on a network located in 190 countries. Now, if you read this statement very carefully, delivery of securities to nearly 7,000 financial institutions. आपने नाम सुना होगा FFI, FDI and FI का?
Yes, sir.
Right, what is FDI?
Foreign direct investment.
Wonderful. What is FI? FII, FII को क्या बोलते हैं? Foreign Institutional Investment, right? So this means if anybody outside India, in, say in US or Canada, wanted to buy shares in our Indian company, then they have to come and operate with the use of SWIFT. Because SWIFT is the one which is going to offer the delivery of securities or transfer of securities from payment for the securities across the international network. Please do remember these two words very clearly, SWIFT as well as CHIPS, right? ठीक है प्रज्ञा?
Yes, sir.
Now, the next is the investment management company. Now, this is again a part of the, if you realize, if you break the word investment management company, a company who is planning, budgeting and controlling the investments will be called as investment management company. I have not given you a new definition. You can just remember management is basically has three functions, planning, budgeting and controlling. So any company who is responsible or who is dealing in planning, budgeting and controlling of investments will be defined as investment management company. Now they are responsible for undertaking only the management of this scheme. Now they are not buying or selling, they are only managing the schemes. Like Reliance ki agar investment management company ke taur par dekhen, to Reliance will be managing this company scheme which they are coming up. They act as a trustee of any scheme. Now the point is, you must have seen bahut sare scam hote hain jisme hum bahut sare financial product laate hain, logon se paisa invest kara lete hain aur fir hum gayab ho jate hain, hum usko forge kar dete hain. So इस सिचुएशन में जो इन्वेस्टर है वो किसको अप्रोच करेगा? That particular person is can approach the management of the particular scheme. Who are the people? Who are the trustee who have brought this scheme? Now launch of any scheme for the purpose of investing in securities, but do not invest in any scheme floated by it. मतलब अगर if I am the trustee of an investment management company और मैं कोई अपनी कंपनी के बोर्ड के सामने बैठकर एक नया स्कीम बनाता हूं, इसके अंदर मैं लोगों को इन्वेस्ट करने के लिए कहूंगा, तो जो मैंने इन्वेस्टमेंट स्कीम बनाई है जिसे मैं मैनेज कर रहा हूं, मैं या मेरा कोई रिश्तेदार डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली उस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम में इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं कर सकता. इट अपॉइंट्स अ ट्रस्टी हु होल्ड्स द एसेट ऑफ द स्कीम फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द यूनिट होल्डर. शुभांकर, इसको पढ़ने के बाद कुछ याद आ रहा है कि ये किस से चीज सिमिलर है? हम लोगों ने कुछ क्लासेस में इसके बारे में बात करी थी. वी हैव यूज्ड दिस वर्ड. उसका शॉर्ट फॉर्म है एएमसी या रिमेम्बर एमएफ. रिमेम्बर वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट एसेट मैनेजमेंट कंपनी म्यूचुअल फंड्स.
यस सर.
Right. So if you look into it, investment management company, that means this is the company who will decide which type of mutual fund they are going to create. There'll be certain trustees. Now these trustees are going to appoint, you know, one person who is known as fund manager, who will be managing the assets of the scheme. जो हम और आप पैसे देते हैं म्यूचुअल फंड में, उसका होता क्या है? Somebody who is sitting at the professional, एक अच्छा professional आदमी जिसको investment की securities के बारे में जानकारी है, वो हमारे द्वारा दिए हुए पैसे को आगे कहीं और इन्वेस्ट करता है और उस इन्वेस्टमेंट से वो जो इनकम जनरेट करता है उसका कुछ पोर्शन वो हमें जनरेट करता है और कुछ अपनी कंपनी को रन करने के लिए यूज करता है. सो द इन्वेस्टमेंट मैनेजमेंट कंपनी मे लॉन्च ओनली दोज स्कीम दैट आर अप्रूव्ड बाय द ट्रस्टी. अपने मन से नहीं कर सकते, ट्रस्टी जो अप्रूव करेंगे वही करेंगे. और सबसे बड़ी बात है जो मैं आगे पढ़ाऊंगा आपको इसमें, दैट इज दे हैव टू गेट रेटेड देमसेल्फ फ्रॉम एनी क्रेडिट एजेंसी. Now, what is Sahil credit rating? मैंने बताया था. We have discussed what is credit rating. Chivankar, you can also say.
Sir, एक minimum मतलब कि एक rate set करते हैं ना, उसके हिसाब से एक rate का ज्ञान
है. No, no, no. What is credit rating? When we buy certain products on Amazon. Are you listening?
Yes, sir.
तो उसमें हम लोग स्टार रेटिंग देखते हैं. इफ यू आर ऑर्डरिंग फूड ऑन जोमैटो यू से दैट देयर आर 5-star restaurant 3-star restaurant और जिस स्टार जिस रेस्टोरेंट को कोई रेटिंग नहीं होती हम उस रेस्टोरेंट से खाना मंगाने में डरते हैं. ऐसा क्यों?
क्यों सर, खाना खराब हो सकता है?
वी हो नहीं सकता बिकॉज यू आर दैट पर्सन हैज नोबडी हैज रेटेड दैट पर्सन राइट. सो Amazon में अगर हम कोई प्रोडक्ट देखते हैं तो वो लोग हमारे से फीडबैक लेकर क्या कर रहे होते हैं? एक तरीके का वो प्रोडक्ट की वैल्यू को रेट करवाना चाह रहे होते हैं. Now, if many people are rating it as 5-star, 5-star, इसका मतलब क्या है? This product is जैसा दिखाई देता है वैसा ही है. तो similarly, if I say I am running an investment management company, then how people will trust me? वो मेरे पास मेरे द्वारा स्कीम में क्यों पैसा लगाएं? कल को मैं पैसा लेके भाग जाऊं तो? So what I will do is after doing this, जैसे यूनिवर्सिटी को यूजीसी ग्रांट अगर ना मिले, for example, Rama University does not have a UGC grant, UGC accreditation, then what does it mean? Anybody can open the university, anybody can run the course to get the credibility that yes, this university is as per the rules and regulation, UGC ki uske upar ek stamping chahiye, right? So same way, agar aap koi as investment management company chala rahe hain, to kisi aapko credit rating agency, kyunki ye third party hogi, wo aapke kuch document check karegi, aapke trustee se baat karegi, aapki schemes ko evaluate karegi, aur phir aapko ek rate degi, maybe 2-star, 3-star, 4-star, 5-star. ये एक इन्वेस्टर को गाइडिंग फैक्टर होगा समझने के लिए कि ये जो स्कीम है ये कितनी बेनिफिशियल है. am I right?
Yes, sir.
Done. फिर इसी तरह से आगे बढ़ते हैं. We'll find that another intermediaries could be the merchant bankers or the investment banks. Now, by definition, if we look, merchant bank may be defined as an institution. ये भी बहुत सारे काम करता है. हम लोगों ने पढ़ा भी था और आगे मैं पूरी क्लास लूंगा इस पर. ये मैनेजमेंट ऑफ कस्टमर सर्विसेज, ये पोर्टफोलियो मैनेजमेंट का काम करते हैं, क्रेडिट सिंडिकेशन का काम करते हैं, दे एक्सेप्ट क्रेडिट काउंसलिंग एज वेल एज इंश्योरेंस. नाउ मर्चेंट बैंकिंग के केस में, बैंकर्स के केस में, यू मस्ट रिमेंबर वन थिंग, दे आर नॉट डायरेक्टली यू नो इन अ कमर्शियल वे गिविंग मनी एंड टेकिंग मनी. दे आर द फैसिलिटेटर्स. जैसे अगर हम एग्जाम्पल मर्चेंट बैंकर का समझना चाहें, Amazon इज नॉट सेलिंग ओन प्रोडक्ट. Amazon is not selling its own product. What Amazon does, Amazon is basically acting as a mediator. Some people want to sell, some people wanted to buy the products. Amazon bring them together in a common platform, right? I think it shows that the time is running out. Hello?
Sir, abhi thoda sa hai time.
Kitna time hai? अगर हम देखें तो मर्चेंट बैंकिंग की सर्विसेज में बहुत सारी सर्विसेज यू कैन सी. आईपीओ का मैनेजमेंट करना थ्रू प्रोस्पेक्टस, मार्केटिंग, अंडरराइटिंग, प्राइसिंग ऑफ इश्यूज, दीज आर द थिंग्स व्हिच आर ऑफर्ड बाय द मर्चेंट बैंकर. Nowhere they are involved in taking deposits from people, they are giving loans to the people. ये ज़्यादातर वो services mediator का काम करते हैं जिसमें उन लोगों को एक साथ जोड़ते हैं जिनके पास बहुत सारा पैसा या securities हैं और उन लोगों को जिनको पैसे की ज़रूरत है या और उन लोगों को. तो एक तरीके से merchant bank is a type of a guarantor sitting in between the purchaser and the seller, या the funds provider and the funds seeker. Now we move ahead. This investment environment, may, as I rightly said, with mutual funds, you will find that there is a person called the fund manager. Now, what is the fund manager means? If we realize management say draw kara hua hai word manager, which means a person who plans, budget, and control the funds related to any investment scheme will be called as fund manager. You don't have to remember the definition. Try to understand jo main samjha raha hu. Fund manager means a manager of a fund, yeah, any manager who manages, plans, budgets, and controls the funds of any investment scheme is called as a fund manager. A fund manager sells units of fund to investors at net asset value and are also ready to purchase units from the investor at the net asset value. Now, in case of no load fund, now fund manager, the types of funds which are there, there are two types of fund. One is no load fund and the other is called load fund. Now, no load fund, now ye bahut important cheez hai, dhyan se suniyega. The no load fund, here the fund manager sells directly to the investor. Now, here, which means, otherwise, humne shuru mein padha tha, there are two types. One is the brokerage, the other is the dealer. Now, when I say if any mutual fund is being there, if it is categorized as no load fund, which means, here the fund will be sold by the manager directly to the investors who are willing to invest. एक तो ये हो गया. द नेक्स्ट इज देयर इज अ लोडेड फंड. नाउ इन दिस लोडेड फंड देयर विल बी अ सेल्स पर्सन और अ डीलर और एन व्हाट यू कॉल इट एज अ ब्रोकरेज हु विल गाइड द इन्वेस्टर इन मेकिंग द इन्वेस्टमेंट. नाउ इन दोनों में आप नॉर्मली सोचते होगे, जैसा आपने अभी सुना तो उससे लगता होगा कि सर अगर आपको इन्वेस्टमेंट की ऑप्शन दे फंड मैनेजर तो आप नो लोड फंड खरीदने में इन्वेस्टेड होंगे कि लोडेड फंड में इन्वेस्टेड करोगे.
नो लोड सर.
राइट, लेकिन गलती यहाँ ये हो रही है. नो लोड फंड में भी कॉस्ट इन्वॉल्व है, लोडेड में भी कॉस्ट इन्वॉल्व है. नो लोड में लोड फंड लेने में एडवांटेज क्या है, कोई यहाँ पर जो सेल्स पर्सन है दैट इज द ब्रोकर, he is responsible for giving you professional advice. No load fund mein you have to take the risk on your own. Yahan cost zarur kam hai no load fund mein, koi cost nahi dena, koi commission nahi dena kyunki hum direct khareed rahe hain. Lekin isse nuksan ye hai ki after sale services ka naam suna hai aapne, right?
Yes sir.
So yahan par advisory koi nahi milegi, ye decision hamara hoga, hum decide karenge and we'll purchase the fund. But in loaded fund, we are definitely paying the front end load and the back end load on purchase and sales. But here we are also getting the advice or the professional guidance. Am I right?
Okay.
Thick. And then we move ahead to the mutual fund. And I'll just give you an introduction to mutual fund. And before we close for today, it is a fund. Mutual fund is a trust that pools the savings of number of investors who share common financial goal. Anybody with an investable surplus or of as little as few thousand rupees can invest in mutual fund. These investors buy units of a particular mutual fund scheme that has a defined investment objective and strategy. Jaisa maine bataya tha, now mutual fund means hamara, mutual means in between, your fund, my fund. Now I'll just, before I close, I'll just give you a small brief. Remember kuch samay pehle there were companies known as chit funds.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, you sir. Yes,
heard
sir.
About these small fund companies operating inside a small colony where, you know, the workers, like, jo hamare ghar pe kaam karte hain, un logo wahan jaakar paisa jama karte the, wo unko lalach dete the, aap aaj 100 rupaye jama karenge to ek hafte baad aapko 1000 rupaye milenge. Remember those things? Right? So then what happens? Ki is tarah ke ye log paisa collect karte the aur one fine day puri dukan ko gayab karkar gayab ho jate the. To bahut sare jo weaker section hai unke paise ka ye scam kar dete the. So then in that case the government decided, yeah, financial industry decided to bring about a concept called mutual funds, which means small as 500 rupees se hum apni SIP systematic investment plan kar sakte, shuru kar sakte hain. Ye paisa hum jo jis bhi fund mein lagate hain wahan par ek fund manager hota hai. वो फंड मैनेजर हमारे द्वारा दिए हुए महीने, हर महीने या यू नो एक साथ दिए हुए पैसे का आगे फर्दर इन्वेस्टमेंट करता है, वहां से इनकम जनरेट करता है, उस इनकम से वो फंड्स के ऊपर हमें डिविडेंड देता है और जो बचता है पैसा उससे वो उस फंड को ऑपरेट करते हैं. Am I right? So the mutual fund is basically a trust, जैसा मैंने अभी बताया था मेरे एसेट मैनेजमेंट कंपनी के बारे में, जो पूल करता है सेविंग्स ऑफ नंबर ऑफ इन्वेस्टर्स हु शेयर अ कॉमन फाइनेंशियल गोल. So anybody with an investable surplus as little as few thousand can invest in that. Or ye hamare investment objective or strategy ko dhyan mein rakhte karte hain. Right? So tomorrow we do have a class, I believe. Hello?
Yes, tomorrow sir.
Class?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Hai,
kal hai. Inform all of them to be there in time, right? So for today we are just signing it off, right?
Okay.
Right? Okay, thank you. I will share the presentation with you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Bye-bye.